I thought I heard you out here.
Hi.
Hi yourself.
Hi.
Miss me?
Always. Did you have any trouble?
Well, there are a few reporters still camped outside, and one sneaky fellow at my place.
Did they bother you?
No, actually, I'm getting better at avoiding them.
Oh, well, you don't have to do that kind of thing anymore. These are the dresses.
Mm-hmm. I want you to pick out your favorite.
I already have the little one, the black one, the tight one.
The little one, the black one, the tight one. This one?
Yes.
Figures.
Yes. Oh, you look particularly beautiful in that.
Uh-huh. So where are we going tonight?
It's the thank you dinner for all my campaign workers and supporters.
Oh, that's still on.
Of course it's still on. They deserve a reward. They also deserve an explanation, but I think everything will come clear to them once I make my announcement.
What are you going to say?
You'll see.
Am I going to like it?
Yes, I think you are, but let me surprise you, right? I'm going to get dressed.
Okay.
Tonight, it's just not going to be the same without Roger being there.
Well, I can track him down if you'd like.
Huh. I thought he was still angry at you.
Well, he is, but he doesn't know that we're back together again. I think he'll still talk to me.
You shouldn't have to do that anymore. It was just wishful thinking on my part anyway.
What, seeing my dad?
Well, you remember in The Wizard of Oz what happened to the Wicked Witch of the North?
Yeah, she turned into a puddle and disappeared, right?
Exactly.
This is my father you're talking about.
I know, I'm sorry, I can't help myself. I would just like to see his reaction to my news, that's all.
Well, it must be something if you think it will have this kind of effect.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Well, all I can tell you is that's going to put an end to all the gossip, and it will reassure everybody.
And you won't tell me anything else?
No, you're going to have to wait, just like everybody else, but I guarantee you, you'll love it.
I can wait. Okay.
Since he's on his way over here to make some really big announcement.
It's about time he came out of hiding after leaving us all high and dry.
Mm.
Tell you, you better have something to say, because I sure do.
Oh. Blake, sometimes I just have to pinch myself to make sure I'm not dreaming you. You just take my breath away.
Thank you, thank you. You look pretty nifty yourself.
I mean, this is just... Oh, wait a minute, something's missing.
What?
You wait right here. I'll be right back with
him. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, you deserve an explanation as to why I've given up my seat in the Senate. I am not the first man to give up political ambition for the love of a woman, and I am certain I will not be the last. Ladies and gentlemen, the rumors are true. I am deeply in love with Blake Thorpe. And I've come to realize that no office, however exalted, can compete with the calling of the heart. And my heart belongs to her. Forgive me if I've disappointed any of you, but I cannot live without her. And as the poet says, with your body and your speaking, you have spoken for everything. You worry that I'll leave you. I will not leave you. For traveling is for strangers. And owning everything, I have nowhere to go. Miss Thorpe, will you marry me?
Miss Thorpe, I would like you to have this.
Oh, Ross. Ross, these are exquisite.
Guess what?
What?
They belong to my mother.
Are you sure?
They were my mother's favorites, and I am positive.
Okay.
Perfect. Well, are you ready?
I have never been more ready in my life.
I didn't contribute $1,000,000 to your campaign so that Roger Thorpe could be down in Washington trying to get somebody in as your replacement.
Look, you know that if Thorpe gets this permit, we're ruined. How could you do this to us, bro?
Come on. Seems like the only thing you'd be thinking about is Roger Thorpe's daughter. What, are you out of your mind?
No, Billy, I'm not out of my mind. But I am in love.
Okay.
May I have your attention, please?
All right.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, because of your hard work and your abiding faith in me, I've achieved the goal of a lifetime. And yet I stand here before you tonight, having turned down that great honor. I'm painfully aware that some of you are angry and confused. And you certainly deserve an explanation as to why I have given up my Senate seat. I am not the first man to give up political ambition for the love of a woman. And I'm quite certain I won't be the last.